I recorded this video in a couple of different sections, so hopefully it all flows well and makes sense. If I repeat something, forgive me. I forgot that I had recorded that earlier, and just look at it as a little bit more emphasis on what you need to know. Okay, this lesson is going to review Sarah, the subject pronouns and the conjugations of ser, and then we're also going to look at how ser is used. So a quick review, if you want to say I, it's yo. If you want to say you, it'd be tú. If you want to say you formal, it'd be usted, which you can abbreviate just UD, but that stands for usted. L, making sure that it has an accent, otherwise it says the, but with the accent it's he. She would be ella, not ella, but ella. Alright, and then for we, it's nosotros. You can abbreviate it, N-O-S. However, that's not, you can never just write, it's not nos, it's nosotros. Later you'll learn about nos, and it's not the same thing as nosotros. You can never just say nos, but you have to say nosotros. You can write it nos. If you want to say all of you, it'd be ustedes. You can abbreviate it, U-D-S, but it's ustedes. More than one he, so they, would be ellos, with no accent. More than one she, which would be they, would be ellas. So we have I, you, you formal, he, she, we, all of you, they, and they if you're talking to only girls. Alright, so ser means to be, and so I am would be yo soy, you are would be tú eres, you formal are would be usted es, he is would be él es, she is would be ellas. We are would be nosotros, somos. If it's just a group of girls, would be nosotras, nosotras, somos. All of you are would be ustedes son. They are would be ellos son. They being just a group of girls would be ellas son. So soy, eres, es, somos, son. Remember that because each of these is different, you don't have to use any of the subject pronouns, although you can if you want to. So the next question is, how do you use ser? Right? There are two verbs that mean to be in Spanish. There's ser and estar. Later, we'll learn how to conjugate estar, and we'll learn how it's different from ser. But at this point, all you know is ser. So soy, eres, es, somos, son. Don't forget that Spain has all of you indicating just casualness rather than the respectfulness of ustedes, and that would be vosotros, and it conjugates sois. However, I'm not asking you to know that. You can if you want to. So how is ser used? First of all, it's often used to describe characteristics. So characteristics are permanent things about somebody. So saying what your profession is, describing your personality, describing what you look like, those would all be characteristics. Another thing would be possession. So saying whose car it is. It is Juan's car. That would be possession. And then it's also used with time. And we'll talk about time at a later point. Today we're going to focus specifically on possession. I don't think I mentioned this specifically, but ser is also used when describing somebody's profession or their occupation. And we will talk about that briefly. So in English, when we want to express possession, usually we add an apostrophe S, or if there's more than one thing, S apostrophe. So if we wanted to say the student's iPads, we wanted to indicate that the iPads are of the student, we would say the student's iPads. If you have more than one student, it would be students with the accent after the S, iPads. However, in Spanish, you never have an apostrophe. You have accents, but you don't have apostrophes. Apostrophes never indicate possession in Spanish. In Spanish, you have to say the iPad of the student, or the iPad of the students, if it's plural. If you want to say Mr. Fox's class, you'd say the class of Mr. Fox. If you wanted to say my brother's iguana, you guessed it, you'd say the iguana of my brother. But there are also more complicated sentences, such as this one, my sister's husband's mother. So the mother belongs to the husband, and the husband belongs to the sister. So what you would say would be the mother of the husband of my sister. So the mother of the husband of the sister. So let's try to translate these into Spanish. We're just going to say iPad or iPod for iPad, since I don't know how to say that in Spanish. So, the iPad of the students. We're going to say, I'll just say that it's masculine, I don't know what it is. We're going to say el iPad of would be they. They can mean either of or from. So, el iPad, they, and then students, we have more than one, so we got to say the for more than one student. De los estudiantes. If we want to say the class of Mr. Fox, we're going to say the class. So clase is feminine. It's going to be la clase de Mr. Fox. If we want to say the iguana of my brother, and I think I forgot an R there, the iguana of my brother, we're going to say la iguana de. You guys don't know how to say my yet, so let's just say the. So, that should be the. So brother is masculine, they, el, and you don't know this one, but we're going to say hermano, which means brother. If you looked it up on a dictionary, you would find that. Now notice here we say they, el. The they and the el makes a similar sound. And so you combine the day and the L, and it becomes del. So to express possession, or to say that somebody owns something, you would use the verb ser plus de. Ser being like is or are, and de means of or from, in this case, of. So if I want to say the car is Mr. Fox's, I would say el carro es de Mr. Fox. Another sample sentence would be, it is the class of the professor, and we're going to assume that it is a male professor. Okay, before I do this sentence, I should explain to you that they plus L becomes del. Why? Because they and L have a similar sound. So if you say they L quickly, it becomes del automatically. And so you just write it del. However, la does not have the same sound. They la There is no combining of sounds there, so it stays de la. Likewise, de los, even though los is more than one L, it stays de los because you don't have to worry about the E and the L combining into one word. So the sentence was, it is the class of the professors. So it is the class would be es la clase. Okay, we want to say of the professor. Remember that professor is masculine. And so we're going to use L. They and L becomes del. And then, so es la clase del profesor would be saying the same thing as it is the professor's class. Okay, I'm going to give you a couple of sentences to write, and I want you to translate them. Pause the video, translate them, and then check your answers, and feel free to correct any mistakes that you made. Alright, so pause the video and translate these sentences. Okay, so the computer is Mr. Fox's. We're saying that it is the computer of Mr. Fox. Remember that you cannot ever use an apostrophe to show possession in Spanish. So, the computer is of Mr. Fox. So, la computadora is of Mr. Fox. So, es de Mr. Fox. Number two, it is a student's program. So, it is a program of the students. Es el programa. Remember that even though programa ends in an A, it's actually M-A, which makes it masculine. So es el programa de los estudiantes. And I'm just going to stop there because I don't have room to write that. Don't forget that it's los because you have more than one student. The next one is, it is the driver's bus. Notice that the driver is male. So, it is the bus of the driver. Es el autobús de, and then we would say el, but de el becomes del conductor. You can also use ser to show where you're from. So again, that would be ser plus de. So the same thing that shows possession also shows where you're from. So if you are from the U.S., you would say soy de los Estados Unidos. We'll talk about this more in class, but it's important to say that you are United Statesian, because if you say that you are American, a lot of other people in other countries in the continents of America say that they are American as well. It's similar to saying European, but American. This is a continent of America, and so if you say that you're American, they will say, I'm American too. And what's interesting is they actually, countries in Central America say that the North and South America are one continent of America, which is different than what we believe. We believe that there's North America and South America, two separate continents. They believe that it's one continent of America, and therefore they are also Americans. Anyway, to say where somebody's from, you say soy de. You also use ser to talk about professions. So I am a teacher. I would say soy maestro. You are a student. I would say tú eres estudiante. Notice that you don't say un maestro or un or una estudiante. You just say soy maestro, tú eres estudiante. For some reason, you don't use un or una
after said when referring to profession. In English, we do. We'd say Marta is a teacher. In Spanish, you just say Marta is teacher. I don't know why. That's just how it is. All right. Take the practice that you have done, and I want you to upload it to Moodle at this time.